And it's easy to just talk shit up under your breath, man. We all can do that, man. That's easy as hell to do, man. I can give you some bullshit opinion where you can't hear me at. Alright? But the hard part is to come on the street and actually talk like a man. Actually talk to be heard. That's hard to do. For you niggas.
Alright? It's a light of fiction to us. But at the same time, even coming out to these elements, you know? Being out here in the rain, sleet, hail, snow. You know what I'm saying? We doing that because we sincere with our works, man. These people not sincere. You got these camps taking breaks off. Even Jehovah's Witnesses are taking a break off, man. I ain't going out there, nigga. I'm snowed in. Fuck that. I ain't leaving. You know what I'm saying? This is Ezekiel 3:17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
So we're a watchman for our people, man. We're watching out for you people, man. All right? We're doing this out of love for our people, man. All right? But y'all people don't, y'all don't care about us, man. Y'all think that we trying to put a stumbling block in front of y'all, man. All right? Y'all think that we trying to be more righteous than y'all, man. Y'all think that we trying to boast ourselves to be something, man. Hey, I'll be the first one to say it. Hey, I'll be the first one to say it. We ain't shit, man. All right? Y'all feel better now? We ain't shit either. All right?
Hey, if a nigga's talking about what about if I'm having the best, that's more feminist shit. Well, what, say something to make me feel good. Like Halle Berry on Monster Boy, like do something to make me feel good. That's the spirit you niggas in, man. Come on, man. Hey, say something. Hey, the scriptures tell you that a wise man love correction, man. All right, so if you wise, you not, if this brother rebuke me, I'm not going to be like, oh, you got to talk to me like that. I'm like, damn, hey, all right, bro. You know what I'm saying? You caught me slipping. I'm going to go repent and try my best to keep rolling, man. You know what I'm saying? But you niggas go smooth words and shit. And the funny part about it is it's usually the niggas who have women sitting over there just being quiet. Even if they don't agree with it, they'll just sit there like, okay, you niggas the ones that gotta hook up and do, what's this neck shit, man? You niggas with all that feminine ass neck movement and shit. And the Lord gonna destroy you niggas, man. The scriptures tell you that an effeminate can't enter into the kingdom of heaven anyway. So the Lord ain't with you weak ass niggas, man.
That's right.
It's pussy.
That's right. Ezekiel 3:17, son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word of my mouth and give them warning from me.
Yeah, we warning y'all people what the Most High is about to do. He told us to give y'all warning from him, man. Hey, we warning y'all that the Lord about to destroy this place, man. He about to destroy America, all right? And if you don't repent and come back to the Heavenly Father, you're going to be destroyed. Giving y'all a warning, man. All right?
Hey, Salah, and that nigga that was talking shit, he wasn't even catching a bus right here, man. Just talking shit. Just like, come on, man. That's going to be required of you, man.
Yup. But that's some bitch made nigga.
Yeah. How you going to talk? Nigga, you 10 feet away from us, man, and you talking up under your breath and on some bullshit, man. You a hoe, man.
Yeah, that nigga a bitch. Zephaniah chapter 1, verse 14. The great day of YAHAWAH SHEMIAHSHAH is near. It is near. It hasteth greatly.
That's what we telling these people. That's what we warning them, man. We trying to warn them that the Most High about to wreak havoc. Hey, the Most High is about to hit this whole hella hard. You hear me? Yeah. Hey, shouts out to Apostle Rakan and all the other Christian people. The Most High finna hit this whole hella hard. You know what I'm talking about?
It says, even the voice of the day of YAHAWAH, the mighty man shall cry there bitterly.
Huh.
So you strong men, you want to make your face stronger than adam and stone, because I skipped that verse. I want to make your face hard and want to look away when we talking to you and shit, man. It's gonna be required of you what you said, as the brother said.
It's a lot, but you see it says the strong man shall cry bitterly. What about you? How much more you bitch ass niggas? Like a nigga like that, nigga, you go.
The scripture talk about men's heart failing them. This nigga like, this is gonna have a heart attack. That nigga just gonna give up the ghost, right? Like, yeah, Elizabeth, this is the big one, yeah, nigga.
Check this out. This is St. Matthew's chapter 12, verse 36. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak
they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment.
Yeah, you're gonna have to give an account for that in the day of judgment, man. Alright? See, it ain't gonna be no mercy in that day. See, Jake don't realize that this is mercy, right? Yeah. Just us being out here reading the scriptures is mercy from the Heavenly Father. Because he has every right just to be like, you know what, man, fuck these niggas and just destroy everybody, man. And all of you niggas, including us, man.
Hey, and the way that they gonna give an account, man, is by fucking dying. It's not gonna be no talk. It's not gonna be no conversation. It's not gonna be no dialogue where the motorcycle, oh, so you did, you said this. Why did you say this? Yeah. What was the reason? You know, like how when they got down, you get jammed up, you know, for murder or some shit, and Esau come in the interrogation room, like, why did you? We just wanna know why. What was your reason behind it?
But no, the thing is, like the brother was speaking earlier, the Most High gonna put it in your spirit. You're gonna be getting tortured or something to die in a grievous death, and you're gonna see that day you fuck with us. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All right.
That's gonna be the only thought that's gonna replay in your mind time after time again. You'll be trying to get it out your head and you ain't.
Yeah. Cause you know, when you die, your life flashes before your eyes. Yeah. This is a part of their fucking life. They seen us, man. And this is gonna be a significant part of their life, because this is a spiritual thing going on right here, man.
Not only that though, they done seen us multiple times down here. This ain't the first time either.
So that's even worse, man.
Yeah, they gonna replay multiple events. You know what I'm saying? The Lord will probably put in their head. Remember, I stretched out my hand and no man regarded. You talk about Zephaniah when he snapped their shoulder away, man. You know what I'm saying? We out here trying to tell you this truth, and y'all don't give a damn.
And it's always Jake, man. You got the so-called white man that's standing here. You either berate his ass with insults, like, fuck you, you going into slavery. Da-da-da. He's just standing there like a ticket. Yes. All you tell Jake don't eat pork. Yeah, that nigga flip out.
Who
is y'all? Like that bitch-ass nigga over there was saying, who is y'all, you know, to say something. You know, that's Jake's spirit, man. Because they actually think who they call God or Jesus Christ is going to come have personal conversation with them. And the funny thing about that is, when the Lord was on the scene, you niggas did the same shit to the Lord, nigga.
That's what the scripture just said.
Y'all did the same exact thing to who you call Jesus. He was out there speaking, all right, and y'all was talking shit, man. That's, y'all couldn't wait to put the Lord to death, man.
Oh, that's the perfect scripture. Read that. Because the Lord, he was a poor man. He was poor. He ain't had shit. So they looking down on him like, who is this broke ass nigga? This nigga is a bum. Yeah. This nigga got on sackcloth. He think I'm about to listen to him? You know, because our people are vain, man. If I ain't mistaken.
Yeah, Sirach 13 and 23. When a rich man speaketh, every man holdeth his tongue. And look what he says.
So, he says Sirach.
Ecclesiasticus. It's in the Apocrypha. Yeah. Like my scriptures already got it.
I got it right there.
But it's 14 books.
14. Yeah.
They took out of the Bible.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Out of the original King James.
Yeah, out of the original King James. That's another way you know. So white man know this is truth, man. Because when you read the Apocrypha, man, it's a lot about his destruction is in here. Like the book of Ezra, both books of Ezra, you know what I'm saying? Just for an example, it goes into the white man's wickedness and his destruction, or like the Maccabees. Mm-hmm. It tells his about how the Greeks and the Romans and shit like that. God. So their history is in here too, but it's all wicked and they try to hide it. But of course, it's coming back out now.
Yep.
But, I got
yeah,
come on. Sirach 23, Sirach 13 and 23. When a rich man speaketh, every man holdeth his tongue and look what he saith.
Yeah, so when a rich man speaketh, every man holding his tongue. If we was rich, man, if we was out here, if we were like prominent people in this society, like a lot of people knew us, everybody would hold their tongue. And see, if Pastor Vernon was right here, everybody would be listening to what he got to say, man.
Like,
all right?
You know that nigga Jay-Z, he trying to drop wisdom and knowledge and shit about all this shit, and niggas just be thinking it's so deep and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But when we walk by, we just some regular niggas, 9-to-5 niggas, or they think like we don't work and shit, we don't have no source of income, like...
We don't got no life.
Yeah, like we just sit in the fucking house all day, you know what I'm saying?
Bitch asked me that last night.
They extol it to the clouds.
They extol it to the cloud, man. Meaning they praise everything that they rich man said. Bro, listen, bro. He telling the truth. He made it in this society. He got it. He got a plane. He got the jet. He got woo woo woo. Cause our people think that off of material gain and financial gain, they believe that the Most High is dealing with you, man. All right? Because if you're doing good in this society, the Lord is dealing with you. The Lord has blessed you. The devil bless you too, man. Like, that's what motherfuckers don't know.
Killing and over a piece of paper.
Yeah, a piece of paper. And that's exactly what it is. The Federal Reserve note ain't shit but a piece of paper, man. All right? Our brothers went down. They did a video, man, in front of the Federal Reserve in Atlanta. Because it's 12 Federal Reserve banks in America. Did y'all know one of them was in Cleveland? All right? You can go.
Kill me over this, bro.
Yeah, they'll kill you over that. But in the Federal Reserve, they shredding that shit up in a paper shredder every goddamn day, printing new every fucking day, man. Because that shit ain't nothing, man.
It says, but if the poor man speak, they say, what fellow is this?
So when the poor man speak, our people, the people on his side, they look like, who is these niggas? Who the fuck is these? Who told these niggas? These niggas think they know the Bible, man. Who the fuck is these niggas?
And that's the spirit that, that's what that nigga was just doing.
Yeah.
He was just like, exactly, fuck is you. Yeah. That's how Jake beat, man. You know, that nigga was just, because he was, that's why he was getting mad, because Jake feels like, we do all shit. Like the brother said, we ain't shit.
I just said it.
You feel me? No, it's not like we don't go off. But
we ain't roasting this. Yeah.
When we go off, it hurt. You feel me?
Yeah, we're ashamed.
We ain't ashamed. That's the perfect word. We're ashamed of ourselves in this flesh. All right? We pray to the Lord for forgiveness and shit. Y'all niggas just keep doing this shit. Even when somebody tell you it's wrong, yeah, nigga, okay. Y'all say it's wrong, nigga. But y'all don't give a fuck, man. So that's why. But that's going to be the characteristics of the elect. You know what I'm saying? They're going to try to fight through that. It's, you know you got it. That's
Go ahead. Get that.
Which one?
Ecclesiastes.
You said 10 and what?
9 and 16.
Oh, Slaki, I got a little bit more.
Oh, okay, okay.
It says, and if he stumble, they will help to overthrow him.
Yeah, that's it. Like that's what they try to do. Catch us in our speech. Like, say some shit that's wrong. Oh, see, nigga, I told you. Yep. I told you. You know, that's what they try to do. The same way that they did your own shot.
Exactly.
They try to catch him up. Matter of fact, get that in Luke, the 11th chapter, what I told you earlier.
I got you.
Yeah. That's what they try to do. They try to catch us up in our words when we say something. They rape children. They rape girls and shit. You try to catch us up in our words, man. You know, our fucking people, man. Our own people, man. That's what, hey, man, a lot of brothers hate the people on this side more than the fucking white man. Because these are people, man. This is our fucking people that we trying to help them receive salvation, and they ain't got nothing but evil to say about us, man.
That's right. So all in all, man, like you said, they will help to overthrow them. How? We just had an account over here like a week or two ago where you had the nigga, it was an Edomite in a wheelchair, right? An Edomite in a wheelchair, he had to wait till his little friend came before they could be, they had to have power in numbers, man. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because it's power in numbers. They waited till another Edomite came to want to start bucking up against the truth. But the other time, he was just sitting there quiet, holding his peace for the most part. Just accepting the fact that he know he an Edomite.
That's what right now.
Yeah, you got it.
This Luke 11:53, and as he said these things unto them, the scribes and the Pharisees began to urge him vehemently. And to provoke him to speak of many things.
Yeah, so they wanted him to keep, you know, prophesying. Because they wanted to basically examine what he was saying, man. They would, like, want to critique it and break it down. Like, what he's saying, they wanted to be like, oh, break it down. They on our own interpretation. And that's what our people try to do, man. You know, they, when they hear us speak out here, they try to say that we saying something wrong. Or we saying something contrary to the Bible. We say fuck or bitch, all right? Or pussy. All right? Because we got the Bibles in our hand. We doing something wrong. All right? Hey, but majority of our people, they don't understand. They don't even know the goddamn definition for the word curse, man. You ask them what does the word curse mean, they couldn't fucking tell you, man. All right?
They don't know the definition of the so-called curse word they use.
Exactly.
All of them got a different meaning behind it.
Verse 54, laying wait for him and seeking to catch something out of his mouth that they may accuse him.
Yeah, that's all they do to us, man. They just laying wait for us, trying to catch something out of our mouth that they can accuse us of. Oh, they say they gonna kill babies. You know?
The scripture said that shit.
Yeah, exactly. But when you go into the scripture, though, Oh, that is good. Because Griffin don't say that. Y'all breaking it down, bro. Y'all going off y'all for our own interpretation. You know? That's what our own fucking people do that to us, man. And we preaching about the salvation of you people. About y'all going to heaven. Y'all going to be kings, man. Hey, ain't you ready to be a king, son? You ready to be a king? You ready to rule over the people that ruled over you? All right? Hey, I'm pretty sure you're familiar with slavery, right?
Jim Crow laws.
Yeah, Jim Crow law and all that. Ain't you ready to rule over those people who had our people in slavery? Our ancestors, our forefathers? Hey, ain't that true justice, man? All right? That the slave become the slave master? Isn't that true justice? Hey, but that's what we try. What? Hey, but that's what we preaching to our people, man. We preaching to our people that we was the slaves, man, and we gonna become the slave masters. But our people don't want to hear that shit, man.
I don't want no slaves. Why everybody can't be happy?
Cause you weak. Hey, you weak. Right now.
Somebody, I got power on my nuts, nigga.
You weak. You weak. You weak. You weak. Hey, we were just getting into it. God. Hey, that's the spirit. This nigga making a prime example of himself. You see it? We preaching about the kingdom, about the goddamn the so-called white man who had us in slavery, who fed our babies to alligators, who hanged us on a tree, that's raped right. our women, that's even right. raped the men.
That's right.
And this weak-ass nigga.
That's right.
This weak-ass nigga.
That's
we right. ain't gonna do all that wickedness, man. We gonna rule in righteousness, dummy.
It's called righteous indignation. It's
we gonna rule in righteousness, dummy. All right? Hey, because Jake, man, you don't know shit, man.
I can't tell you. You don't know shit, man.
You a dummy, man.
You standing right there, nigga. Where your life at?
You a my life is this scripture, right? That's what my life is, dummy.
That's why the scriptures call our people Sodish Jews.
Let's see what these niggas
is. This shit won't be right here for that shit.
Hey, both of you niggas are dumb. Hey, if the book was made by
a right man,
the fuck you stupid.
Bro, you a dumb nigga, man.
The fuck
you a dumb weak nigga.
I gotta get better by disrespecting on my nigga.
You a weak nigga, man. Hey, that's the prime example of fucking Stockholm syndrome.
Stronger, nigga.
Stockholm syndrome.
Somebody weak, my nigga.
Stockholm syndrome.
Stockholm dick in your mouth, nigga. Get some balls out your life.
He a faggot.
Get in the community, help these black people, nigga.
He a faggot.
You preaching a white man's word, nigga. They wrote that book, nigga. Boss up, nigga. Boss up.
He a faggot.
You're
a dumb nigga, man. A dumb nigga. A dumb nigga, man.
Who liked to be from the projects, man? Who liked that shit?
I don't forget where I come from.
You dumb nigga.
You own this fucking world.
You come from Israel, you dummy.
Not doing this fuck shit.
You ain't got no fucking plan or nothing.
Y'all believe in a religion, nigga? White man.
No, you dumb nigga. You dumb.
Nigga.
Stupid.
Dumb niggas.